Hi everybody, so this video is going to explain the different tools that are available to you in the essay portion of MindTap. So the first thing to show you is that you can drag the screen down and make this window bigger so that you can see all of the information that's being presented. The next thing to point out to you is that there are 5 tabs up here, and I'll go through and explain them all. So the first tab I'm going to explain to you is the My Tutor tab. And the My Tutor tab is telling you about the 5 different areas that MindTap will be looking at in your essay. So focus, content, organization, language, and mechanics. And we can click on these and you get different information. And basically what these tabs do is they tell you what you're supposed to be doing to write well in this area. So to write well in mechanics, you need to make sure each sentence has a subject and verb. And it's telling you, hey, if you read aloud, sometimes you can hear your mistakes and correct them. And oftentimes it will say, you know, what it might look like before revision and then what it might look like after revision. So I'm not going to go through and read all of these to you. I think that you can do that on your own. You don't need me to do that and make this a longer video. But that's what the My Tutor tab does, is it gives you information about these 5 different areas. The Writer's Model tab is a little more funky to look at, but once you kind of get yourself oriented, it should make sense. So the Writer's Model tab has 6 different sample essays that are written specifically for the writing prompt for the chapter that you're in. So you'll get different sample essays for the different writing prompts as you move through the semester. And the 6 essays are examples of essays that go on a scale of 1 to 6 of quality. So this, for example, is an essay that would get a 1 across these 5 areas. And these 5 areas should look familiar to you. So we have focus, content, organization, language, and mechanics. And here we have focus, content, organization, language, and mechanics. And the essay that's receiving a 1 is all the way at the bottom of that feedback. So here's the essay that receives a 1. So this is pretty short, and I think anybody could agree that's way too short for an essay. And you can see that under each heading, what the commentary is on how well the essay achieves focus and meaning or content and development. So then you can see what a 2 essay is like. So here's the 2, here's the actual essay, here's a 3, here's the actual essay, all the way down to what an essay would look like if it received a 6. So again, this is going to show you sample essays for the specific writing prompt that you're working on that would receive a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6 across the different areas of writing quality. So now let's say, okay, you have an idea of what your topic is, what are these different areas of writing quality and what you need to do, and you've looked at the sample essays and you have an idea of what a good essay looks like and what a bad essay looks like, and now you're ready to start writing. So you're going to click My Editor, you're going to tell it that you're writing in English, so now you're going to start writing. So I, of course, I'm going to write a really bad essay because I want it to flag a lot of stuff. So I'm going to say, I'm not going to write. Writing sucks. Okay, so now I've written this, and I'm going to refresh up here. And now you can see that it's flagging what I've written. And so let's look at this. So it says, I'm is a contraction. That's not really that formal. That might be something you need to pay attention to. And here you have gonna, and again, it's informal, and it's telling you that's something you need to pay attention to. I want you to notice that it's not flagging sex. This is because I want you to see that you still need to use your own brain and read your essays. You can't just kind of sit back and let the software find every mistake. It knows down here that this is not a word, but it's not getting flagged up here. So you need to be paying attention to kind of all the information that it's telling you. So you can write in here whenever you've added new content that you want it to check out for you. You hit refresh and the new content pops up here and it will flag the things that it's worried about. If you want just a clean screen where you're not having to worry about anything up here, you can click editor only and then type all your essay and then go back into my editor, tell it again that you want to do English, and it will analyze your whole essay. And once you're done, you hit submit and score. So that's it. If you have any questions, as always, please feel free to email me.